Today we're gonna make this into the
whole content.
No filler.
Except this. Go to Google, just go to Diffusion 5.2 or whatever version it's out right now. You go open it up and always like to save a copy to you have your own exclusive version in your drive. There you go. Close the old one, change the name, and then it's going to make you terminate the other session because it's still running in the cloud. Google Colab Notebooks. If you're here, you know how to use Google Notebooks. There's a million tutorials on YouTube about it, so I'm not going to get into all those details. Now, terminating this other session, the original one. All right, close that. Now, tick the box. Here's the pecking order of GPUs. I have a Google Pro account. P100, I think, is the best I can get on that. You gotta restart the runtime to speed it up. Boom, retick it. Now you see, all done.
All done.
Go down, link your Google Drive. So save something to it. Boom, there's mine. Rick York,
common sense
made simple. Yeah, install this, use CPU. I tried doing that once, I don't know, got all buggy.
So
I didn't mess with it again. Right click and I'll go to form, hide code. I'm not a coder. I hide the code because it just makes my nose bleed a bit. I ticked R 40 times for, I noticed it increases quality, but it also makes things take a bit longer, so it's optional. Name, that's supposed to be whatever it saves, and your Google Drive. Steps, I mean, you can calculate different steps. I do 1, 2, 4. As for the width and the height, you have to match your video for this or else it'll be all wonky. But I like to shrink my videos down to 320 by 320 in After Effects for a square design. Later on, I'll upscale them via other notebooks or software. These numbers have all I've just done from months of experimenting with various numbers here and there. I've also read Zippy's cheat sheet, which I'll attach in the description, which explains exactly what all this does. Cause like I said, I'm not a programmer. I just tick buttons.
Your push button.
And here we go. Let's get this code out of here because the nose is bleeding a bit. Video inputs. Now this is where you want to drag in your footage. There we go. I have this, which I've already shrunk down in After Effects, which iamYork, Hell's Kitchen, use whatever works for you. So here we go. Tick that. Copy the path. Put it in here. Paste it. Put it in there. Paste it. And I delete that.
Is for OCD.
I suppose these are all pretty much default settings. Default 1500, so I like to go 2000. 50 works for me usually, so that's what I use. Here we go, extra settings. All right, I'm gonna get rid of the code as usual. Hemorrhage brain right now. Go down, down, down. Cut power. Notice this makes things a bit sharper, so I don't know. 30 from my experiments has worked well. Go up everything, ding, ding, tick that, tick that.
Hurry up!
Go on there. Now we got that, tick that. Now the description, here we go. First off, I got rid of this. It's, I don't know, it even says it's not very good, so why am I gonna use it? After that, we got this. I'm not gonna be changing the scenes, it's too annoying. Color scheme, yeah, I don't know. It adds like a dot of color here and there. It's doesn't always do much. Now the setting here, I don't know, training on ArchStage and all this stuff, it's too crazy to get rid of that. So let's just do something nice and happy. Like I'm always like to stay positive, you know, sad robot crying, dying.
What positive head, what? But,
whatever. Detailed painting by Jeff Christensen. If you're not familiar with him, he's an amazing artist. Check it out. Check him out. Buy his stuff if it's for sale. I don't even know. 4K photorealism. I feel like just sharpens it up a little bit, you know. So I just put that in. Obviously, everybody has their own prompts, so you try what you like and what look you're trying to go for. Boom. All more code. Get rid of that. We got display array batches. Create video. We don't need that right now. And now we're gonna do the run. And the robots are gonna do all the work. It's great. One day we'll all stand in the bread line together, paintbrush in hand, and yeah. See it run. Come on, run, 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 run,
run.
I'm probably prepping. Yeah. Wow. The excitement just it never ends. All right, so there we go. That's the first image, and it's gonna. Whoa, it's getting fast now. Whoa. And this is what I'm talking about. You gotta stick around, because if Google will kick you out if it thinks you're a robot, even though it's a robot itself. The robots hate robots. It's an ongoing thing. Why we'll just never figure it out. I sped it up. This is all done. Now you can either do what I do, go into My Drive AI Disk of Diffusion images out, and there's the view source. You can download it, and then you'll have a PNG sequence, which if you're familiar with After Effects and all that stuff, then you could do it that way, or Photoshop or Blender or whatever, or you can just do it a simple way here, which if you just want the straight raw video, boom, and
raw
frames per second is 12 or whatever you want. And I have to uncheck this, skip, untick that, run it again, and then it'll save into your drive, which we'll look at in a second. Boom, image is out. Let me refresh this. Image is out. There it is. Boom, you downloaded your video. And here it is. That's what it looks like directly through the notebook if you download it. You know, I personally like to take it into After Effects. I'll be doing a part 2 tutorial showing you what I do next with those steps if you're interested. Also, I've listed all the settings in the description just in case you don't want to keep redoing the video and writing it down and going back and blah, blah, blah. So you could do this yourself and follow up. And of course, follow me on Instagram and all that, TikTok, Twitter, tag me. I'd love to see what you do with this. It'd be really cool to see people using this and the way it took months of experience for me to get to these results, and it's just so crazy. This is Google Notebooks and AI animation. If you have any questions, ask me in the comments. Love to be involved with. Check the description for the readable references and come back and enjoy this more. This is my first tutorial, so if I sound weird, ignore that part. And to see you soon, and come on back, man.
iamYork Imagery is a boutique design, animation, and visual effects studio in Hell's Kitchen, New York City.